Impact investing has many, many forms. In the area that we're most focused on, which is how to bring capital to organizations that, because of their missions, are for various reasons difficult for a conventional investor to support. If we're trying to work with those kinds of organizations where they may have a high degree of originality and innovation, making them very novel and risky as a result, or perhaps serving very, very low-income people, and so their margins are constrained and the returns that they can pay may also be constrained. If we're trying to work with those kinds of organizations, say an affordable housing provider, as I mentioned, or a community-based grassroots arts organization that's doing wonderful things, educational activities for kids. If we want to get to those kinds of groups, often there are just barriers that make them a bridge too far for a conventional investor. And the role of a private foundation in that situation can be to bridge that gap, to provide just enough risk mitigation through a guarantee, or to provide just enough subsidy by accepting a lower than usual return so that we can kind of square the circle and then make it possible for the other money to come in, blend with our money, and then we have a result that works.